today's session, we will be learning about adding and subtracting two different fractions. In our previous session, we learned all about fractions and different types of them. Today, we will learn how to add and subtract two fractions. If you remember, I asked you one question in our previous session. I'll answer that question somewhere in the middle of this session. So, let's begin. Adding two fractions is very simple. It is just as similar as adding two whole numbers if the denominators are same. Let's start with one of the easiest examples. There are two friends. One ate half chocolate and the other ate half. So, what is the total chocolate that they had? So, here we will add 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2, which gives us 2 by 4. But practically, when we see, it looks like that the answer should be 1, right? What we have done is actually wrong. We can never add the denominators of fractions. Now, you may ask why. Let's have a practical look at this thing. You had half part of the chocolate and your friend had the other half. Now here, when we add the denominators, we can see that in total we have 4 parts, but that is not true. We only have 2 parts, right? So from this, we conclude that we add 2 different parts of the same whole, and hence we do not add the denominators because it represents the whole. So finally, it will be 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2, which will give us 2 divided by 2, or you can write it as 1. This was an example of adding two fractions with the same denominators. But then what happens when the denominators are not same? You and your friend are jointly working on a project. You have completed half of the project and your friend has completed 1/3 part of the project. So now, what is the total number of projects completed by both of you combined? Now here we need to add 1 by 2 and 1 by 3, which will give us the total amount of project completed. Now since the denominators are not same, can we directly add them? If the denominators are not equal, the fractions will represent two completely different entities. And hence, by making the denominators same, we make the fractions common and they can be added now. In our previous session, we learned that how we can make the two denominators same by taking LCM. So, for 3 and 2, the LCM is 6. And now, we can calculate the total project completed, which is 5 by 6. Finding the LCM, then adding them is a little lengthy way to add these fractions. Here, we will add the fractions using a new and an interesting method known as a butterfly method. We had two fractions, 1 by 2 and 1 by 3. We will try to make a pattern which will be very similar to a butterfly. First, we multiply 1 into 3 and we write it at the top left corner. Then we multiply 1 by 2 and write it at the top right corner. And then we multiply both the denominators and add the numerators, which will give us to 3 plus 2 divided by 6. That is 5 by 6. Aren't the answers same? This is known as a butterfly method because it looks like a butterfly. And this will make you remember this method also easily because of the name. But don't get too much fascinated by the name itself. Do remember the logic too. Now using this method, you can either add or subtract any two fractions. This is also known as cross multiplication method. Now adding two fractions was really easy, and if you understood it completely, then subtracting two fractions will be far easier. So here, now we will subtract 1 by 4 from 3 by 4. Now since the denominators are same, we can directly subtract them and the answer comes to 2 by 4, or we can further write it as 1 by 2 in the form of simplest fraction. But when you have fractions like 4 by 3 and 5 by 4, how will you subtract them? So before deciding anything, we will make the denominators of both the fractions the same. Same like we did before adding two different fractions with different denominators. Now here the LCM for 3 and 4 is 12. So after making the denominators equal, the fractions formed will be 16 by 12. And 15 by 12, we will subtract 15 by 12 from 16 by 12 to obtain the answer as 1 by 12. But then what would have happened if I would have subtracted 16 by 12 from 15 by 12? That would have just given me minus 1 by 12, which is nothing but just a negative fraction. Negative fraction is nothing but just a fraction which belongs to the negative side of the number line. So, before leaving, can you add and subtract these fractions? And do comment the answer in the comment section below. So, here we are done with addition and subtraction of fractions too. I hope you liked this session and understood all the concepts related to fractions. Comment if you have any doubts and do subscribe to our channel. Till then, keep watching, keep learning.